Naomi, for inviting me to be a part of this event. And thank you folks for sticking around. It's great to see some faces, happy faces in here. I'm actually going to start with a poem called Now It Is Broccoli from this collection called October Light. It is a book of poems written by Jeff Tagami. See a show of hands here, you know who Jeff is. Thank you. So I want to pay tribute to him. He just passed away last week. I miss him dearly. And he was one of my role models. Now it is broccoli. My mother, who loses a piece of herself each day, is bowing before the conveyor belt as a river of broccoli rolls by under the fluorescent. All night at the canneries of J.J. Grissetti, she trims the yellow and bunches the green, trims and bunches, until the colors blend and she is lost before this river of one color that is neither green nor yellow and unable to hold it back, lets it slip past her. She remembers once in another shed slicing off part of her index finger. It wasn't the pain or horror she remembered, but how the day was hot and the shade of the corrugated tin roof bore down cool on the back of her neck, and the metal click of the spinning rollers echoed in her ears long after the crates had passed. It wasn't the kindness of the floor lady turning off the machine that she wanted to remember, the floor lady who would just as soon bark at her like a dog. It wasn't the concern of the forklift driver who searched between the chopped heads of cabbage, thinking the finger could be sewn back. No, it was the face she longed for, that serene face she lost years ago. A face the young woman across from her now owned, who did not once look up from her work, who smiled as if remembering a silly joke or the slight tremble of her boyfriend's lips as he kissed her goodnight. Now she keeps the finger in the freezer in an envelope with a plastic window. Because it is still a part of her, she cannot let go. Like her man, who pickled her miscarriage in a bottle of alcohol, could not let go. For 2 years, he kept it beside the bed. Each night, he held it up to the lamp, stroked the glass clear of his choked breath, as if to contemplate a son without future. Finally, as if that bottle could no longer contain his grief, he buried it beneath the porch steps near the mint. Now it's broccoli, and my mother must be careful, though she has given up 40 years to the passing of vegetables, though she knows the knife and the fat, clumsy fingers that betray each other, though she knows broccoli is only a river through which we carve our simple life. Her raised knife wavers in the air while the colors go on playing tricks with her eyes, and the nail of her clipped finger slowly turns black behind the box of frozen peas and the ice cubes. A couple of poems from Martina Meditations on the South Valley by Jenny Santiago Baca. Love this book very much. And like Jeff Tagami, Jenny is very good at writing the stories of the folks that the master narrative has left behind or erased. Cruising back from 7-Eleven esta mañana in my 56 Chevy Traquita, beat up rankled farm truck clanking between rows of new shiny cars. Hey fella, trees need pruning and the grass needs trimming. A man yelled down to me from his third story balcony. Sorry, I'm not the gardener, I yelled up to him. Funny how in the valley an old truck symbolizes prestige and in the heights, poverty. Worth is determined in the valley by age and durability, and in the heights by newness and impression. In the valley, the atmosphere is soft and worn. Things are shared and passed down. In the heights, the air is blistered with a glaze of new cars and new homes. How many days of my life I have spent fixing up rusty broken things, charging up old batteries, wiring pieces of odds and ends together. Those lovely bricks and sticks I found in fields, I took home with me to make flower boxes. The old cars I've worked on endlessly, giving them tune-ups, changing tires, tracing electrical shorts, cursing when I've been stranded between Laguna Pueblo and Burque. It's the process of making do, of the life I've lived between breakdowns and breakups, that has made life worth living. I could not bear a life with everything perfect. Okay, last poem. El Pablo was a bad dude. Presidente of the River Rat, 700 strong, from 67 to 73. Hands so fast he could catch two flies buzzing in the air and still light his cigarette. From a flat foot standing position, he jumped to kick the top of a door jamb twice with each foot. Pants and shirt creased and cuffed, sharp pointy shoes polished to black glass. El Pacuchon was cool to the bone, brother. His initials were etched on junior high school desks, Castaneda's meat market walls, downtown railway bridge, on the red bricks at the civic auditorium. Uptown and downtown, El Pacuchon left his mark. Back to the wall, legs crossed, hands pocketed, combing his greased back ducktail, when a hyena walked by, cool to the huesos. Now he's a janitor at Pajarito Elementary School, still hangs out by the cafeteria, cool to the bone, El Pato, still wears his sunglasses, still proud. He leads a new gang of neighborhood parents to the Los Padilla Community Center, to fight against polluted groundwater, against developers who want to urbanize his rural running grounds. Standing in the back of a crowd last Friday, I saw Pablo stand up and yell at the civic leaders from City Hall. Listen, Juarez, you pick up your weapons, we'll fight you on any ground you pick. Thank you very much.